And we are back with one more question of exercise 1.4 of chapter 1, NCERT Exemplar for class 10. So now question 4 says that for any positive integer n, we need to prove that n cubed minus n is divisible by 6. So take some time, give it a try, and after that you can come back, and when you are ready you can see the video and you can find out the solution. Before starting up with the solution of this question, please share, like and subscribe our videos if you like it. Let's try and solve this question now. It says that we need to, for any positive integer n, prove that n cubed minus n is divisible by 6. So we can start with that. Let a be n cubed minus n. That means if we can take n as common, we are left with n squared minus 1. And we can write it as 1 squared. So by applying the formula of a square minus b square, we'll be getting a minus b and a plus b. So n into n minus 1 into n plus 1. This is something which we get a. Now we can see that n minus 1, n and n plus 1 are consecutive integers. So what can we say? So out of these three, one will be divisible by 2. How come? Let's say we have any three consecutive integers. We can take anything, any three consecutive integers. Let's say we have 4, 5, 6. So there is at least one number which is even, that is divisible by 2. Let's say we have 3, 4, 5. 3 and 5, they are odd. But still we have 4. That means if we have 4, then it is an even number which is divisible by 2. So out of these 3, we can write at least 1 is divisible by 2. Now let's take out the sum of these integers. So there will be n minus 1 plus n plus n plus 1, which will be 3 times n. Now can we say, since the sum of these integers is 3n, then 3 consecutive integers, that means n minus 1, n and n plus 1 is divisible by 3. As we know the rule, if we have 3 digits, if we have digits and the sum of all these 3 digits is multiple of 3, we can say that it is divisible by 3. Let's say we have a number 2, 4, 3. So 2, 4, 3, if we'll add all of them, we'll be getting 9. So 9, since the sum is 9, we can say that it will be divisible by 3. So ultimately what did we do? We come up to know after that that some of these integers, some of these numbers, or you can write integers or you can write number, sum of these numbers is n minus, which is 3n. So clearly we can see that sum of these three numbers, let's just write it more clearly. We can see that clearly the sum of three consecutive integers is divisible by 3. Now we can say a is n minus 1 into n plus 1. We know that the sum is divisible by 3 and it is also divisible by 2. Now since it is divisible by 2 and 3, can we say that this product, which is a, is divisible by 6, as at least 1 of it is divisible by 2 and 3. So we can say that for any positive integer n, n cubed minus n is divisible by 6. So what did we do? We preferably try that it is divisible by 2, then we prove that it is divisible by 3. So ultimately it will be divisible by 6. Thank you so much. Stay tuned, we'll be coming up with other videos too. Thank you so much.